We are joined once again by Dubris Martial Arts. This is Peter Dubris. He is the founder, the owner.
Owner, founder, co-owner, myself and my brother.
You wear many hats.
Many hats.
So we were talking about cardio kickboxing just a few minutes ago and how that's an excellent workout for people. But you also specialize in self-defense as well. Why did you want to include that?
Well, the karate program is part, self-defense is part of it. You're learning your basic techniques, your movements, and then you just learn to, it's very empowering to know how to protect yourself. Mm-hmm. And the stigma that everybody has about karate is it's violent, and there's, you know, we're bullies and stuff like that. The whole thing is different. If you look at our logo, it's a man kneeling in a very calm position. Mm-hmm. And that's the way I think about it. Don't make him stand up. If you make him stand up, then there's gonna be some trouble. But the whole thing about self-defense is just knowing that you can protect yourself and giving yourself that inner confidence that I think everybody should have.
Okay, so what are the girls doing right now?
Right now they're driving their knees into the pad, and that's simulating grabbing somebody and driving the knee into the groin.
Okay, it looks like a bit of a workout.
Yes, fitness is the key.
Do you need to be in good shape to be able to defend yourself if you're ever put in a position like that?
It helps, but no, you don't have to. My self-defense is very practical, it's very easy, and I just have some basic rules that people should follow, and it's pretty simple.
What are the basic rules?
Number one, hitting either above the neck or below the belt. See, the body absorbs a lot of punishment.
Okay.
So if your first initial strike to protect yourself is hitting the body, that usually doesn't work. I like to break the center. So either hit below the belt, so somebody's always bending. When you hit them, they're always gonna be bending this way. If you hit in the face area, they're always bending back. So it's very hard for somebody to come after you when you're hitting them and they're doing this or they're doing that every single time.
Right.
So you keep them off balance. That's pretty simple.
Okay. Do we want to try a move or two?
Sure.
We'll give the girls a break. They're probably exhausted back here. Yeah. What will we do first, Peter?
We're gonna learn how to escape from grabs.
Okay.
So before we made our fist in cardio kickboxing, we had our fingers up and we closed them. So knowing, looking at the hand, we have four fingers, we have one thumb.
Mm-hmm.
When somebody grabs you, the fingers are the power of the grab. The thumb is the weak part, okay? So if I grab the wrist and you push down towards my fingers, it's hard to get out.
Mm-hmm.
But if you turn your hand up, grab it with the other hand and pull straight up,
right,
it's that simple to get out.
Okay.
So what we're gonna do is a front choke, okay?
Okay.
I go right into the nitty gritty all the time, okay? So what's gonna happen is, I'm gonna put my hands around your throat. So what you're gonna do is, when I put the hands around the throat, you're gonna step back with one leg for balance, tuck your chin down to be able to give yourself some time to breathe. Your hands come over the top,
okay,
right by the wrist, and you're gonna slap my hands open.
Okay, so I'm putting my leg back and slapping your hands.
That's right. Now
Sorry.
From there,
that's kinda hard.
Right? From there, you hit the ears,
causes
an imbalance, now you control the head.
Okay.
If you control the head, you control the body, and then you drive that knee up into the groin, just the way the girls are doing on the pad.
Okay.
Okay, so it's pretty simple.
Should we do the sequence?
Sure.
I won't hit you in the head though.
That's okay, I want you to.
Okay, right, no, gosh, no, I wouldn't do that. Okay, let's do it.
Okay, so if I grab.
You have to look more scary than that. No attacker looks like that. Okay, you're very convincing. All right, let's do it.
All right, so I grab.
So
tuck,
leg back,
open,
down,
slap,
pam,
and
then
knee. That's right.
Okay.
And then you run as fast as you can when you're done.
Oh, so you don't stay and fight, you take off.
Oh no, you take off.
Okay.
We're a hit and run type of attitude.
So how does the self-defense program work?
It's part of the karate program. So once you get into the actual karate program, the self-defense, earning your belts all the way up to black belt is part of the karate program that I teach. So it's together, it's combined.
Okay, if you head to the Dubris website, you can look at all of the information because you've got a number of different arts offered, eh?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, we do the karate, taekwondo, I also did that, boxing, and our fitness kickboxing.
Awesome. Peter, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you too, Sarah.
Let's do it once more while we head out to Carlton Place and join up with Melissa Lamb. Come on, attack.
Arr,
all right. Melissa, what's up?